I like your boots. I want your boots.
I can smell the grudge on you like stale beer and Bubba Kush. If you wanna be my
you gotta listen carefully. We got M in the place who likes it in your face. You got G like MC who likes it on a easy V. You doesn't come for free. She's a real lady. And as for me, how you'll see.
I can feel your negative energy from here. Down,
if you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Make it last forever. Friendship never ends. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give.
Pinky swear.
If you wanna be my lover.
You good? All right. I got nothing. Seriously, this has taken on a life of its own. So hi. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Meredith. My pronouns are they, them. I'm on the Twitter, non-binary finery, friends. I am on the Twitter and the Blue Sky as Beer and Crosswords. So you're probably wondering what the heck this panel is all about. I'm right there with you. Honestly, all right, so quick recap. Last year, there was a panel, Kat and Anne, asked Rachel and Kate if they had ever worked together before. And one of the two started improvising and said they'd worked on a project called Swamp Love. It took on a life of its own, okay? Things in our fandom tend to do that, don't they? So we had artists mock up VHS boxes, movie posters made out into the timeline. We're going to do the drawing for that signed movie poster. Y'all helped us raise over $200. And there is going to be a Swamp Love photo op coming up. So Buffy and Allie asked me if I wanted to moderate, and I'm like, all right, but I got to bring the chaos. So I'm going to do Swamp Love. But here's the thing. A certain somebody that we all know and love may have guilted me into watching Christmas Island. I loved it, by the way. So what I did is I made Swamp Love a Hallmark movie. Yes! Does not take place in a swamp, but you'll get there. You'll get there. So we did a little decoration. We did a little shopping trip. There are props involved. This thing has taken on a life of its own. So, without further ado, I want to get our cast out here. Kate Drummond. Rachel Scarsden. Rachel Anchoro. Michael Eklund, and Tamara Duarte. So this is how it's going to work. We have, all of us here, one act scripted. Okay? I am not a writer. I did my best, friends. And I apologize in advance to all of our professionals sitting here and out there. So we have one act of scripted lunacy. You are going to help them finish the story. So we're going to set up things for you, scripted, you are going to give us improv prompts. And our cast is going to act out the rest of the story. Yeah. Sure. All right?
Great.
Yeah, also...
And we got to keep clean, because this is Hallmark.
She's being modest, because... Hallmark actually contacted us after this panel. They were like, we would love to develop Swamp Love into a Hallmark movie.
Yes, yes.
Can you write it? And we were like, not until next year. This is what we're doing.
Okay.
I'm moving it.
I'm in.
Kate screams Hallmark right now.
Hallmark?
Something's screaming. All right, so I want to remind everybody, let's keep it clean. This is Hallmark-ish.
Hallmark After Dark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I bothered to give myself the illusion of having any control here. Ladies.
Love in the flesh.
Gentlemen.
Oh, yeah.
And those beyond the binary. And our swamp monsters.
Yes.
I present to you Swamp Love, a Hallmark movie in three acts. Oh, I'm the narrator. Our story begins, as many do, with our protagonist on a spin bike, sweating it out.
Oh, that's me.
We haven't read this, just so you know. This is new to us.
Wait, what am I doing?
You're on spinning. A spin bike. Meet Cora Barnes, known to her siblings as CB. She's a small town girl living in the big city. She's sweet. She's kind. She's got a line. She's sweet. She's kind. She's even tempered.
Where is it?
Excuse me.
There you are.
Oh. I don't have
mine
in order.
If you think you're taking over this... Oh.
You're on a spin bike.
Think you're taking over this leaderboard, spin bro. You've got another thing coming. Bring it on!
And she's competitive when she's in the zone.
Yeah!
Clear.
Every Sunday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, Cora clips in from her loft in the city and logs onto a remote spin class led by the toughest instructor out there, the monster. Real name unknown. Identity always obscured. Physical studio location. Never divulged.
So mysterious.
The phone rings. Cora has another line.
Wow, I actually just had my phone randomly. Hello?
You have a line.
Oh, hey, PD. No, wait, what? No, slow down. What? When? Yeah, I'll come up tonight. No, I'll meet you at DB at the house. I love you too.
You're breaking a sweat.
I'm literally
okay,
really hot.
Okay, have a sit. All right, have a sit. Cut to the idyllic upstate town of Marshfield, where we meet Lily Owens, a spin instructor. Lily left the big city behind to open her own fitness studio in this small town. Lily is smart and driven and wholly absorbed with running and growing her business, which means she hasn't had the best luck in the dating department. She and her best friend, new age influencer and yoga instructor, Zen Garden, are at Pearl's Cafe enjoying coffee. Come back, you've got a line. Coffee and homemade scones.
And matcha.
Go.
I don't know, Janie.
Call me Zen. Zen.
I can't hear you.
I don't know. No. It's in my boots. Hold on, let me take this off. That's not gonna help. Hello? Hello?
Here, talk into mine. I'm right here.
This is... Oh, that's beautiful. Oh.
Just duck. Thank You're not in this scene.
Sorry.
Okay, sorry, let's go again. I don't know, Janie.
Zen. Call me Zen.
What? Since when? When I moved to this town from the big city, you told me your name was Jane Smith.
Oh, no. I changed my name 2 days ago when I hit 5,000 followers. I just... this is... No. Okay. So that's what I did. I hit 5,000 followers, I changed my name, and I just... I need something more chill, right? More me, more my brand.
Fine, but as I was saying, Zen. Swamp Fitness is the love of my life. I don't understand why you're so focused on partnering me up and marrying me off.
Well, as the Buddha said, true love is born with understanding.
Well, I love you dearly, but you're being weirder than normal.
Maybe it's the 5,000 followers. I have a sense about these things, Lily. I'm super sensitive. And I just, you know, I'm sensing right now that you are going to fall in love. Or get a free cup of coffee. Here comes Zen.
Hi, Lily. Hi, Zen. Can I top those off for you?
Oh, thanks, Pearl.
Matcha?
Yes.
No, that's fine.
Hey. Oh.
Yes.
What's wrong? You're not your normal, chipper, hyper-caffeinated self.
Our grampy died, and I just had to call and break the news to my sister.
Oh, you're... Your sister is she single?
Zen!
Just what? I told you, I'm sensing these things.
Pearl, I am so sorry. Here's a dog. I am so sorry. If you need anything, you let us know.
Thanks. She's headed upstate now and should be here in a few hours.
Okay. A few hours later.
PB? DB? What the fuck was wrong with our mother? Hello? Is anyone here?
Play with us, CB.
This is why I moved to the big city. I hate when you do that, you jerks. It's creepier now that you're adults.
Did she just call us adults, PB?
Not certainly at us, DB. All right, Tweedle dorks. Come here and give me a big hug. I've missed you. What do we do now?
Whiskey toast to Grampy, of course.
To Grampy!
The next day...
Let's get you out from behind that mountain of paperwork. You're out of the house, CB. You're way too invested in... What are you doing again?
Investments.
Lame sauce, big sis. A new gym opened up downtown not long after you left the big city, and they just have the best spin classes.
Give your brain a break, CB. Let's sweat it out.
I don't know, guys. I take an online spin class 4 times a week, and I don't think that there's anyone who could compare to...
A spin class.
A monster.
The who now?
Oh, she's my instructor. She's so mysterious and has the sexiest voice. No one knows what she looks like because she sets it up in the back.
The back. Did you say the back?
The back. The back. The website is a monster, spinner.com. So everyone just started calling her the monster, and it stuck.
Sounds like you have a crush on the monster, CB.
Crush? Me? No. I don't even know her. How can I have a crush on someone I don't know?
Hey, you know, my friend Zen told me that the gym owner herself leads classes here that will kick your butt from the back. And based on your weird online voice crush, that's what you need, CB. A good butt back.
butt kicking, you mean?
Kicking.
Right. That's yeah, right.
No, I mean butt. When was last time you,
Years, DB. Our big sister hasn't been on a date since the Obama administration.
Oh. You mean the first one?
I hate you both. Seriously, though, when was the last time you went out? I live in the big city. I work from home. I get my groceries delivered.
All right, that seals it. We spin it, then we hit it. Right? The pad for burgers and beer. You said you're thinking about moving back here into Grampy's house, right? Mm. So we need to ease you back. We heard you.
We heard you.
So we need to ease you back into the upstate living. You know, Marshfield has a lot going on than it used to.
Okay. We're good for 6 p.m. swim. We're okay for 6 p.m. class at Swamp Fitness. I just got us the last 3 bikes.
Swamp Fitness? What kind of heck of a name is that?
SWAMP stands for Sweat With All My People. I think it's clever.
Plus, we're in Marshfield, so it's punny.
Ugh, I hate puns.
But you love us.
Right?
Meet us in the front of the clock tower at 5:30, and we'll walk over together.
In the front,
in
not
the front,
back.
Not the...
Meanwhile, across town at Swamp Fitness...
Swamp Fitness, this is Lily. Oh, no, I'm sorry. The class is full tonight. Oh, yes, of course you can take it online from home. We'd be happy to have you. Yep, I'll take, I take Venmo. Okay, thanks, bye. Zen, are you sitting in on my class tonight?
Oh, yes.
I'd love to. And then we can go out for, like, vegan tacos and some kombucha?
As long as that is code for gluten-free beer and chili fries at the pad, you're on. Honestly, sometimes I don't know why... Aw. Sometimes I don't know why we're friends.
Okay.
But I do.
Well, you know, I keep you from spiraling.
Oh, well, right now you're keeping me from spinning. Mm-hmm. I have a class in 2 minutes.
Later that evening.
Fruit.
Getting our bikes.
Oh, sweet. Bikes in the back. I'm not sure I can deal with everyone staring at my butt while I tap back.
Should have asked for this script ahead of time.
I told you.
All right. Knock it off, DB. It's a good thing you're between us, PB. Are you, PB? I'm a little nervous who's going to be on this empty bike on my other side.
Oh, hey, there's Zen. Hi, Zen.
Hi, Zen.
I'm over here.
What? Hi, Zen.
Hi.
Can we take that back? Oh, hey, there's Zen.
Hi, yeah.
Hi, Zen.
Hi, hi. Namaste, Dudley. Namaste, Pearl. Are you guys trying something new tonight?
Oh, yeah. Our sister's in town, and we needed to get her out of the house before her head exploded.
She's uptight, needs to blow off some steam.
Yeah, she's wound up.
She's stressed out. And she's sitting right here. Hi, I'm Cora.
Oh, hi. Nice to meet you. Lily's on her way over, and she's going to hop on that bike next to you. Yes. We'll align our chakras later. Later, we'll align our chakras later.
Get on.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's my line. I was just so into this. You must be Cora, the twins' sister.
That's me, Lily. That's me.
Wait, sorry. I'm sorry to hear about your grandfather.
Yeah, it's me. The sister. I'm the sister. I mean, hi. Thank you. So,
spin class.
Oh, no. She didn't notice.
Usually alone in the room when I sweat.
Well, that's a shame. Why did you take that?
It's not what I meant. I mean, how's my mic? I mean, I haven't.
How much chaos.
Spin studio in years, you know, to take online classes from home. Do you take this class? Right. Do you take this class often?
Phoebe, are you seeing what I'm seeing?
That our sister is desperately trying to flirt.
Yeah.
It's 4K HD on the big screen, baby. This is gonna be good.
I actually take this class every chance it's offered because I lead it.
All right, folks.
Let's clip in and get ready to ride. We'll start at 90 RPM for 2 minutes to get us warm and loose.
Oh, no.
Here we go, nice and easy. Make sure that resistance is set at 3, hands at first position.
This isn't happening.
We'll gear up as we go.
This isn't happening.
It's happening.
You okay, CB? You okay?
You're looking so good from back here. It's mountain ride day. We enjoy the flat while it lasts.
It can't be, Petey, it can't be. I know that voice.
Shout out to all you logged, oh, sorry. Thanks. Shout out to all of you who logged into monsterspin.com. Spin bro, you have a shot at the top spot this time since Call Me CB doesn't seem to be here today.
Call Me CB? Cora, Millicent, Barnes, are we taking your virtual spin class in real life?
Jeez. I'm your instructor. They call me the monster. So let's ride.
I have to go. CB, wait. Wait, DB, you're never gonna believe this.
Later at the pad.
I have to go.
I don't know.
Okay. It's the bar. The pad is the bar. Burgers and beer.
Got it. Burgers and
beer. Hey, Zen. Did you know what was up with the twins and their sister? She started choking on air and bolted out of the studio just as we were getting started. And Pearl and Dudley were caught up in a giggle fit the whole time.
Ask them. Oh, just ask them yourself, because the bees just walked in and Dudley is headed right for us.
What did you just call them? The bees?
Yeah, they have really cute nicknames for each other. You'll see.
Hey there, Zen. Hi. How you doing? Hey, scooch over. We're gonna switch into the booth with you guys.
Oh, I. No? I get. Yeah, okay. Keep scooting, DB. I'm sitting next to you.
Looks like you've, oh.
Skip.
Oh,
okay.
Oh. Looks like you're stuck next to me again.
Yeah.
I don't bite.
Yeah, CB. She doesn't bite.
What did he just call you?
We've had nicknames for each other since we were kids. Just our initials. I'm Pearl Barnes, so PB. He's Dudley Barnes, so DB. And she's Cora Barnes, so CB.
So they call you CB.
I have to pee.
She should have stayed for class. She really is wound up tight.
What is happening right now?
I have no idea, but I can't wait to see where this goes.
Neither can we. End Act One. Oh my
Part one.
Gaga. You guys, thank you for that. That, like, amazing. So, here we are. Where are my notes and where are my glasses? Got it. So, we have our meet cute, right? Now we need some conflict.
So,
with some prompting,
what's going on?
All five of our actors are gonna continue that bar scene.
Oh, bar scene?
Yeah, so we need to know, how does CB fare after she returns from the bathroom? How does Lily react? And then, what do Zen and the twins do? Zen and the twins, remember, these guys are the stereotypical best friend, sidekick kind of thing.
Be kind.
So they're gonna plot. The twins and Zen need to plot how to get these two together. CB needs to react as to coming back to the table, and Lily needs to figure out how the heck to get with CB so she doesn't freak out. So we have our meet cute. We're going to set up some conflict, and then we're going to have our resolution, and we have 10 minutes. So we're going to... if you guys want to shout out some prompts...
Do we have to go back to the bar?
Yeah, so we're going to be back in the bar.
Okay, back to the bar.
Oh, we're in the bar. You're peeing. You're peeing.
Start in the front.
Coming back from peeing? Okay.
All right, CB, you got toilet paper on your shoe?
Yes.
There it is. All right.
Wow.
So we know CB's a nervous wreck. Lily, calm, cool, collected, and obviously interested. And Zen and our troublemaking twins are plotting to get these two together. Okay? I'm going to give you guys... We'll start with like a three-minute scene, and then we'll go from there. Let me get my stopwatch going. Stat, go for it.
Here she comes.
Why is she wearing those pants?
She's coming. She's coming.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What's up?
CB, I just talk to you for one... Second?
Can I just dress you up first, though? I just...
Great. We got... There we go.
Zen.
We'll dress you.
Zen.
Hi, yes.
I don't...
Sorry.
I don't think she likes me.
You don't think she'll like...
It looks really good.
She...
Okay,
I have a great idea.
Go.
Wait, stop. I have this shaman.
This is stupid. I shouldn't
spin
instructor.
To me. Yes, you should.
I suck at being a spin instructor.
You're amazing. We need to do some mantras. Say, I am strong.
I am strong. I can't do that right now. Hi.
Hi. Got some water on my clothes.
Had to change.
I think you look...
Casual outfit.
I think you look...
This is my tantric yoga class. Wednesday at 7 p.m.
Wow.
Please join us.
Us?
Number four is quite interesting, actually.
Yeah, that's my
favorite.
Do
you like number four?
Do you like number four?
Yes. This is beautiful.
Thank you.
Where did you get it?
I made it. Nordstrom's.
Nordstrom's. That's
Swanstrom's.
Oh, Swanstrom's. I know that place. Yeah.
Family owned.
Zen?
Yes? Do you need help? Okay.
Tell me what to
take a deep breath. No, like deeper into your pelvic floor.
The diamond shape. You have to, nice diamond shape. And when you breathe in, the diamond shape. Here we go. Okay. 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 So.
It's really breezy in here. It's the wind. The wind. It's hitting me.
Just breathe. You'll be fine. Be yourself.
So you take my class online?
I do. Yeah. It's great.
Thanks. Yeah, thanks. I like to change it up a bit and like do a little role playing.
You know what? We should just have the twins speak for us because we're so nervous.
Yeah. You're doing great.
No, you are us.
Here's Cora.
Oh, here. This is my other tantric yoga class.
So, what level are you on the bike?
I'm on level 6.
Wow, 6.
Isn't that impressive? Look at my legs. Look at my legs.
It's a nice leg.
I know. You got strong biceps. Biceps. Yes.
Can I touch your face?
Do it.
Look at that.
Look.
What a beautiful lift.
Okay. Oh.
First kiss. End scene.
We're just going to do a choose your own adventure with all your brains doing your thing. You guys finish this story. I think we've put these guys through enough.
I feel like everyone worked really hard. They're all really sweaty.
So hot.
So sweaty.
It's spinning. You're namaste.
I'm not sweaty. I smell good.
You don't sweat, you glisten. You shine. I got nothing.
No fun.
Nope. You guys are... I hope you had fun.
We had a blast.
This entire con, I have actually been quite cold until now.
They asked me if it was too cold in here.
I have that effect on people.
How were you? Spinning on the back of a chair didn't help.
So, Rachel and Kate, I know during the Pussy Willows pre-prom thing, you going from table to table, a lot of people were giving you swamp love prompts.
Yes.
What are some of the things that people want this movie to be?
Well,
you're
made.
Just gonna have to watch it. Watch the sequel on YouTube.
Yes.
Where the original lives.
Yeah, there were some amazing ideas. I mean, you know, it was building slowly. I was being redirected with some of my ideas. We are now at a point where the swamp used to be this.
Okay. You have to start from the beginning.
Okay.
For those of you who weren't there, essentially, I am just, once again, a small town girl living by the swamp, having a good life. Come from a long line of witches, potentially. Kate works for an evil organization who's poisoning the swamp. I am filled with rage. And I go to my grandmother and I say, we must curse her! and curse her. But my grandmother warns me, don't curse people, that we are good witches. That's going to turn you into
a monster.
But I do it anyway. Kate is cursed to become the swamp of which she poisons. I go to gloat, still not yet a monster, and I fall in the swamp?
No.
Oh, I just become a monster. So you don't fall
into, you don't fall into the swamp. You become a monster, and you're like, my face feels different, and I'm hideous. And then you go and look at your reflection in the swamp, but there's this face looking up at you. Giving, like, eyes.
Sexy vibes.
Sexy eyes. And you were like, oh, and you're so startled that you fall into the swamp.
Right, and then you rescue me, which honestly it was probably just gonna have to be a bunch of people standing in the water like in blue suits splashing water, because we let's be honest, it's a low budget film.
Yeah.
And I am lifted out of the swamp. At the same time, you are lifted out of the swamp because the curse is broken. We're in love. We live happily ever after. The swamp is restored, and all the creatures have a cameo.
Yeah.
The end.
I like this. Yeah. You're going to write it, right?
We're wondering if we're in the right convention. We have no idea what's going on.
We're so confused.
Just say yes, because you're going to be in it.
Because you're in it. Oh. You play the
You've been adopted into the Swamp Love
I'm a
family.
Mike plays the role of the two-headed tadpole.
Yes.
Because he's been poisoned by the chemicals.
By the chemicals in the swamp.
So yeah. You like it to be the other head then?
Yes. Ooh. You can. Yes. Yes.
I love this. I don't know. I think, Rachel, you could rock a mohawk. I don't know if you want to go that way. So right now, we're going to do the drawing for the Swamp Love poster. This was designed by Jess, one of our photographers. Since this is your first con, I'm going to have you pull the raffle ticket. I can't read that number. Can you read it?
Ticket number 6388277.
No one's looking at tickets.
You're going to have to take this. So we're going to have this at Kate's autograph table. So,
yeah,
I can't read it, dude.
Okay. Do you have a ticket?
6388287.
Read it again.
New number. Here we go. No, it's 6388287. Oh. Hey!
Our winner is here.
For the back of the truck.
Come get your poster.
Come and get your poster. And this fundraiser, just so you know, the money from the raffle tickets raised $218 to go to charity. Thank you guys so much. Yeah, we need to make sure you're not lying.
Whoa.
Is this it?
Yeah.
I read it right.
I know you did. I'm totally kidding.
I trust you.
Which brings between that and the karaoke for canines and the t-shirt sales, oh my gosh, and the donations that were coming in cards, we are, like, we've surpassed $5,000 American. And that's you, that's everyone, that's the energy that this con is, and I've already started dispersing funds to rescues in need. I'm posting it on Instagram and, you know, chatting with other people about organizations that they know need help, and so that money is going immediately to those who need it the most. So thank you all so, so much.
With that, I need to thank all of you. Tamara, Michael, Rachel, Kate. Thank you for doing this. Thank you for indulging my weird brain, our collective insanity. I am merely an agent of chaos, and you have all been deputized. Thank you very much.
You guys are awesome.
You're awesome.
Oh my God.